Welcome to Arco Arena. Before they bring it down, we wanted to give you one last look. Now, right now, we're at the old center court that served to be home of the Sacramento Kings for more than three decades. But I'm going to take you behind the scenes, inside the tunnel. I'm going to show you things that you never would have seen if you didn't work for the team, work for the arena, or play on one of their teams. Let's start with the locker rooms. This is what's left of what was the home for Kings players. This is where they prepared for games, went over plays, rallied at halftime, showered, recovered in the sauna and the physical therapy room. It's also where the last Kings team to make the playoffs huddled in 2006, including Brad Miller, Kevin Martin, and Mike Bibby. Back then, you could hear fans cheering and stomping their feet from this locker room, which is beneath the stands.
The locker room is literally right past the tunnel. As soon as the players came in and out of the locker room, they were in that tunnel.
Kings president John Reinhardt has worked for the franchise for 22 years. He spent most of those years at Arco, making great memories.
The Monarchs championship, you know, just the energy and stuff, but you know, the playoffs in 2000, 2001, and 2002, you know, so many great concerts.
Speaking of the WNBA champs, the Sacramento Monarchs, this was their locker room, located across from the Kings locker room. You could see it was much smaller in size with a bathroom and a room for a trainer. This also served as the locker room for the dance team, which I was a part of in 1999 and 2000. In fact, this was my locker right here. On the opposite side of the arena was the visiting team's locker room. And this locker here at the very end is where NBA great Michael Jordan would get ready when the Chicago Bulls would take on the Kings. Jordan and the Bulls would also have to contend with the loudest fans in the NBA, thanks in part to Arco and the way the arena was made.
Remember, the fans would just stamp their feet and stomp their feet. And when you're stomping on wood and metal, it was like reverberating. We would stomp. I remember stomping and, just the sound of the metal on the stairwells and the risers and then the wood on the bleachers. It was amazing.
But basketball wasn't the only show in Arco. Sometimes the circus would come to town and the clowns created their own locker room of sorts in a cave.
The clown cave was, quite an amazing discovery throughout the years. The clowns from the circus took it over, and they would basically use it as their place to hang out. They would change in there, like there was things for them to have their costumes and whatnot in there. And every year they would all sign it and they would leave their own marks. There's pictures, there's drawings.
The clown cave, which is technically a tunnel, was originally built to connect the arena with a proposed sports stadium that was never built. But the tunnel is the one thing that will remain even after the arena is torn down.
The tunnel is underground, so theoretically it will. This building has so much history with the people of Sacramento and the region, and everybody will have their own individual stories.
Stories that will live on in our hearts forever.